Hey, everybody. It's amazing how the social contract between men and women has changed, and how mainstream women are starting to discover that smart men want nothing to do with them, regardless of how attractive they are. And it's not because more men are becoming gay or transgender. It's because of feminism's war on men has made the prospect of initiating romance with a woman extremely dangerous. Most men by now realize that just approaching a woman can lead to losing one's job, getting expelled from college, and even arrested and imprisoned. And that's just the beginning. It often destroys a man's reputation and his life. However, in the age of Me Too, there are still many of millions of ignorant women who don't understand these simple facts. With that in mind, let's get started. According to Slate's advice column dated April 9th, 2019, Creepshow, I'm an attractive, heterosexual woman who wants no strings attached sex. Where do I find non-creeps for that? Well, the reality is, you don't. Then we go on to Charlize Theron. Now, I know everybody's been talking about her in like lots of detail, especially with this particular article, which is Charlize Theron says she is shockingly single and ready to date. Somebody needs to step up. I've been single for 10 years, not including all the blowjobs, one-night stands, or the relationships that she just chose not to count. And then she says, oh, somebody needs to step up. Well, here's the reality. Why aren't men stepping up? Maybe it's because we read stories like this from the Daily Mail. Exclusive, revealed, honey trap beauty who lured besotted TV executive to his grisly death is now married to a rising labor star and will become a mayoress 4 years after leaving jail, or read, prison. Okay? So this is the woman here. Now, she actually was responsible for the murder of her ex-boyfriend, a TV exec, after falsely accusing him of sexual abuse. Or maybe men are avoiding women because of this particular story from the New York Post from April 4th, 2019. Identical twins both ordered to pay child support after inconclusive paternity test. That's right. So they said, well, you were twins and we want money from both of you for this kid. So we're going to chase you down for money because this woman has entrapped you with a kid. And so DSHS, for whatever state this is from, let's take a look and see what state it's from. Oh, it's in Brazil. So in Brazil, this has happened. So happy feminism to Brazil. So there you go. Again, that's a problem. Men don't want to have to deal with that. And then we move on to Quillette, how the Me Too movement helped create a script for false accusers. And this is true. This is absolutely true, because what it's done is the Me Too movement has mainstreamed false allegations of abuse. And if you don't believe me, check out this article from Reason. High school girls admitted to making false sexual assault accusations against a male student because they just don't like him. Okay? This isn't somebody who dated them. This isn't somebody that like decided that there was going to be, you know, caught him in a compromising situation, or maybe they were both drunk. So, you know, the woman has to be the victim and the man has to be the perpetrator, even though he may have been more drunk than her. This is just, oh, we don't like that kid, so let's go ahead and accuse him of sexual assault. So then on top of that, of all the gender issues at work, men are most concerned about false harassment claims from women. And this is true, because all these men are losing their jobs, they're losing their careers, they're being blacklisted from industries because of all the false allegations for women. Now, this is all common knowledge. This is all mainstream news. Yet this woman can't figure it out. And Charlize Theron apparently lives in a bubble because she can't figure it out either. And the thing is that when it comes to dating and romance, okay, according to the Washington Post, the share of Americans not having sex has reached a record high. Well, of course not. Nobody wants to get an incurable STD, especially like if it's gonorrhea or chlamydia that now have incurable strains. Nobody wants HIV, especially now that there's a drug-resistant version of HIV. And on top of that, false sexual assault allegations have officially been weaponized by men. Absolutely. How are we doing it? Well, number one, we're getting these women arrested. This woman was arrested after filing a false abuse charge. All right? And this is from the Mountain View Voice, again, from 2018. This is happening all the time. This is why these women are afraid to file police reports now. Because if they're lying, they're going to go to jail or they're going to at least get charged. And then they're going to start suffering the consequences of their actions. Okay. And the thing is, and women, just so you guys understand too, the thing that's really striking about this whole thing is that's not all of it. Men are facing more discrimination than women across the globe, especially in the United Kingdom, the United States, and Australia. Okay. All three countries discriminate against men more than women, according to this particular study. Now, all these links will be in the description, but I just want to make sure that, you know, people have kind of a comprehension and an understanding of the scope of the problem. It is now commonplace for men to be discriminated against, for men to be treated as second-class citizens. It's not just for divorced men or homeless men or poor men anymore. It's all men. That's the reality. So, ladies, here's the problem. As long as you adhere to the bigoted teachings of feminist ideology, men will continue to shun you, and the number of men who avoid you will grow. Not just because they're learning the dangers of courtship, but because you're getting older and less attractive. Now, I know that all women listening to this video will think this is shallow, but it's actually very important. Allow me to explain why. Feminism told women to stop cooking, stop cleaning, to stop being wives and mothers. Feminism lionized the killing of unborn children. Feminism lionizes women who cheat or commit adultery. Feminism wrongly demonizes all men as abusers. Speaking of which, every time a man disagrees with a woman, even in just an argument or some sort of conversation, feminists tell the woman that by virtue of disagreeing with her, that man is an abuser and he should be jailed. Feminism has taught women to falsely believe they're perfect and that every man is flawed and thus should be a slave to her every whim, even if that woman is fat or otherwise unattractive. Feminism has taught women to use and abuse men, not to comfort, invest, or encourage them. As a result, most modern women are verbally abusive, dismissive, and are subject to extremely bipolar-level mood swings that make any mental health therapist cringe. For generations, feminism has taught women to withhold everything a man needs from a woman to maintain a healthy, long-term relationship, while at the same time, feminism changed the laws to crucify any man who realizes he's being abused or otherwise taken advantage of, and criminalized any harsh words he may have for the woman responsible for it. So what's left? Sex. That's it. Feminism indoctrinated generations of women to be horrible, unethical, and otherwise despicable people, and then lionized them for it. So with every other virtue of a traditional woman all but dead, all that's left is sexual access. This is not because men are pigs who only want sex, though that's an easy answer to attempt to shame men back to the slavery that is most modern relationships. But rather, it's because women have been taught by feminism to bring nothing to a man's life other than a blowjob and an easy lay. But men are walking away from this as well. With the rise of sex dolls and other sex toys, men don't need women anymore, especially if that woman is old, overweight, or otherwise unappealing. For less than the price of a roughly used car, even the ugliest man can get himself a sex doll that is more attractive than the majority of Western women today, with none of the headaches that comes with dating a modern woman. And if these men want children, they can either adopt or get a surrogate to have a child. So, there's no real benefit to marriage anymore, as long as the discriminatory divorce laws remain so one-sided against men. So where does that leave women? It leaves them alone, slowly but surely becoming more bitter and insane as they grow older and more abandoned, never realizing that feminism sold them a lie from day one. Now, there is an alternative. Women can start realizing that the long-term consequences of feminism hurts them also and start working to eradicate it. Start voting for laws that oppose feminism and its flawed and bigoted ideology while working against the feminist indoctrination that made most modern women horrible in the first place. And then, once the laws are changed and women quit the Thought Lives Matter labor union, maybe, just maybe, men will consider a long-term relationship again. But it doesn't seem like it's going to occur anytime soon. Or you can continue to lament the fact that you're alone and be fortunate that men will pump and dump you and then ghost out when they're done, never committing, let alone leaving you Uber fare to get home. It's your choice. I'm DDJ, and this Red Pill Reality Check has been your dose of Misandry today.